Okay, good to see everybody. What I'd like to continue with now are some definitions and some terms that you need to be familiar with in order to talk about jazz, speak about jazz or music in general. So these will cover some of the more important terms related to music in general, and hopefully we can give you some examples of these terms and how they are used in jazz. The first term I'd like to start with is rhythm. These terms are very difficult, even for someone like myself who's been in music for now, 30 years, very difficult to really define. There are so many different definitions if you look them up on the internet or in a music dictionary. Lots of different definitions of rhythm, okay? Important to know how to spell rhythm as well. R-H-Y-T-H-M, rhythm. And the definition we're going to use in this class for rhythm is the organized repetition of sound, either felt or heard. Okay, the organized repetition of sound, either felt or heard. And again, write these definitions down on a piece of notepaper, or if you're using an iPad or a laptop, keep track of these definitions. I will also hopefully have a link here for you soon with all these definitions written out so you can learn them. So, rhythm, the organized repetition of sound, either felt or heard. Sometimes we don't hear it, but we can definitely feel these rhythms, okay? There's some related terms to rhythm I want to show you on this board behind us. Hopefully you can see this good enough, and if you can't, please send me a comment and I'll stop this. But okay, so some related terms to rhythm. One would be time signature. The time signature. Let me show you what that is up here. The time signature helps us to organize these beats or pulses that we feel or that we hear, okay? So the time signature helps us to organize these. What's a time signature? Well, it's a number, it's like a fraction, okay? And we can use X over Y, all right? The top number refers to the number of beats in each measure. Okay. Number of beats for each measure. Okay, a lot of terms going to come at you now. What's a measure? A measure is the distance between two bar lines. Okay, so this is one measure of music. Okay, I have a bar line here and a bar line here, and we have a measure of music there, okay? So, the X, getting back to the time signature, I'll write that up here for you. Time signature, X over Y, the top number, X meaning the number of beats per measure. The bottom number refers to the note value receiving one count. Okay, so that refers to the note value receiving one count, all right? So we can plug in any numbers for X and Y. The most common time signature in music, whether it be jazz or classical or rock or country, is called 4-4. So a musician might see something like this, 4-4, and what does that mean? Well, the top four means the number of beats in each measure, okay? And the bottom four means the note that receives one count. Now, is it a four note? No, it's a one quarter. It's a quarter note. Do I want you to know how to read music in here? No. Do I expect you to know how to read music? No. You don't have to know anything about music to take this class, but just try to comprehend this. Okay, so we have 4-4, the top four beats in a measure, bottom four, the note receiving one count. This is also called common time because it is so common in music. Okay, common time. Great. Okay, we can plug another few numbers in here. 3-4. What would that mean? You got it. Three beats in each measure, and a quarter note gets one beat. Let's try something else. 4, 8. That would mean 4 beats in each measure. An eighth note gets 1 beat or 1 count, okay? So I hope that's clear. Time signatures help us to group these rhythms that we feel or hear, okay? And also there's another reason that we have time signatures. They tell us what meter we are in, okay? There are 2 different types of meters, what we call. There's duple. And there's triple. Duple and triple, okay? So, duple, D-U-P-L-E, refers to music that can be divided by 2s. Triple is music that is felt or divided by 3s, okay? So we have time signatures. They tell us what meter we are in, and there are 2 different meters that we normally work with. Duple and triple meter, okay? So let's think about a tune that we all know, Stars and Stripes. Bum bum ba dum bum 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 ba dum bum bum ba dum bum. That's in duple. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay? And again, almost every piece of music that you listen to is in duple meter. Okay? What would be a good example of a triple meter selection? Well, something like Happy Birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. 2, 3, the birthday. 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, 1. Okay? Usually when we're in triple meter, we feel like swaying back and forth. Ya dum bum be dum bum ba dum bum be dum bum. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Duple meter, again divided by 2, lots of marches. Lots of your pop music is in duple meter. There are also some exceptions to these meters and to these time signatures. There are time signatures which are, or meters that are called odd meter. Okay, we also have odd meter. That would be something that really is not divisible. Something like 5-4. 5-4 is a piece of music that is an odd meter. Okay? Dave Brubeck had a tune called Take 5. Let me see if I can find it really quickly for you here. And this is an odd meter. Okay. So this is going to be in 5-4. And here we go. Four, five, one, two, three, four, five, one, two, three, four, five, one, two, three, four, five. That's a very popular piece of music written in odd meter, 5-4 time signature. You can hear the piano and the bass and the drums in the rhythm section there to recap some of our other class, okay? And we also have meters called mixed meters, okay? Mixed. So we have duple and triple, which are our main 2 types. We have odd meter, and we have mixed meters as well, okay? What would mixed meters be? It would be putting 2 different meters in the same selection. Okay, and that's another, more of an exception to the rule than the rule in this particular style of music. Okay, so that's rhythm. Review the video if you need to. The organized repetition of sound either felt or heard. We have time signatures, and we have meters associated with rhythm in music, okay? Jazz music is very special because it uses another musical device called syncopation. Syncopation, S-Y-N-C-O-P-A-T-I-O-N, prominent in jazz music. And what that is when syncopation is when we place an accent on a normally unaccented part of the beat. Okay? So instead of going one, two, three, four, one, two, we'll divide that beat up. One, da, 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 da. I'm syncopating that particular piece of music right there. Okay, I'm emphasizing the normally unaccented part of the beat. Okay, lots of different types of music use syncopation. For instance, I'm going to sing you a little melody right now. Two, three, four, one. Bum 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 bum. Now, listen to the way the Beatles treated that melody. They syncopated it in this particular selection. One, two, three, four, one.
Da, da. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun.
Okay. So what I sang was one. Bum, 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 bum. And what they did was one. Bum, 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 bum. One. Bum, ba, ba, ba. They accented the normally unaccented part of the beat. And we find that all the time in jazz. Syncopation, it's fun to say too. Ba-do-da-di-da-do-do-do-do-da-da-da. Accenting a lot of the normally unaccented parts of the beat. Okay? So we have rhythm, syncopation. We've already spoken briefly about harmony. The way I define harmony is a support system consisting of chords, which usually accompanies a melody or a soloist. Okay? So the harmony is a support system made up of chords that usually accompanies a person playing the melody or the solo. Okay? When we speak of harmony in jazz, we're really referring to the chords and how they move along. Something we call chord progressions, okay? A progression of chords. All right, so we have chords that make up the harmony. Another important concept in jazz is something called chord symbols. All right? Chord symbols. Let me show you how those are written. Hopefully you can see this. Okay? I wrote an F and a 7. What that is a chord symbol. There you go. That's a chord symbol. And what does that do? That is a guide for the improvising musician and for the rhythm section. Okay? It's a guide for the improviser and for the rhythm section. It's really a type of musical shorthand. It's an easy way to tell the players what notes to play in the chord. Okay? What that really represents is this. Okay? It represents those four notes. Now, I don't expect you to know what those four notes are. You don't have to know them. But all that you have to know is that writing F7 is easier than writing all those notes on the board. Okay, so chord symbols, a guide for the improvising musician and a guide for the soloist. They know exactly what notes are being played. Okay? Do you remember what we talked about when we were talking about the piano and chords? What is our definition of a chord? Okay, again, we spell it C-H. A chord is two or more notes played at the same time. Okay? A chord, two or more notes played at the same time. All right, we're going to end this lecture right here, and then I'm going to continue on with some terms here on the next video.